In the final part of our tutorial on MATLAB and Psychtoolbox, I will talk about the data output from the four assignments on number representation. These experiments were designed to have two input formats. The N shown to participants is either in Roman numerals, which is digital, or participants may see several dots and have to perceive the number of dots through estimation or counting. This is an analog format of presentation. The second factor that we varied was the task that participants do. They either evaluated the magnitude of the number relative to a reference 5, or judged whether the number was odd or even. You can see that the four experiments fall into the cells of this 2x2 design. Here are the average data from 10 participants who completed experiment 1. We display reaction time for each of the 8 Roman numerals shown to them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, and 9. One thing you can see here is that reaction time is not flat. Rather, it increases as the digit goes up from 1 to 4 and decreases as the digit goes down from 6 to 9. In other words, what we see here is a numerical distance effect. The closer the digit is to the reference number 5, the longer it takes participants to make the response. Thus, even though the visual input itself is in digital format, our mental representation of the number is in an analog format. Here are the data from 10 participants who completed experiment 2. We see an even clearer numerical distance effect, where reaction time is slower when the number of dots is closer to the reference point than when it is farther away. When you have one or two dots, it's obvious that they are less than 5, so reaction time is fast. Similarly, when you have 8 or 9 dots, it's obvious that they're more than 5. You really don't need to count to have an approximate estimation of the quantity. But when you have 4 or 6 dots, you can no longer reliably estimate its quantity, and you end up spending more time counting. The effect here is stronger in experiment 2 than in experiment 1. Experiment 3 displayed Roman numerals for participants to judge whether it is odd or even. We can see that reaction time is relatively flat. There is a slight but not statistically significant trend that reaction time is longer for the larger than the smaller numbers, but for the most part, the odd or even representation appears to be uniform across all digits. The data are entirely different in experiment 4, where people judged the parity of n number of dots. Here, reaction time is very fast when there were 1, 2, 3, or even 4 dots, but it's much slower when there were 6 to 9 dots. Notice that the scale here is much longer than the scale I used for the other three experiments. Similar to experiment 3, the odd or even task requires an exact representation of quantity. However, the quantity is not directly shown to participants as Roman numerals, so participants would have to extract the exact quantity. Our data showed that the small numbers can be rapidly extracted, but the large numbers will need to be counted. In the range of 6 to 9 dots, the reaction time curve is roughly linear, with a slope of about 270 milliseconds per dot. Coincidentally, 270 milliseconds is roughly how long it takes for an English-speaking adult to pronounce a count number. So in this range, they're essentially counting. Not so down here. The set of experiments reveal the three number systems that adults possess. We have an approximate number system that enables us to estimate the number of dots. The system is imprecise, hence it shows the numerical distance effect in experiment 2. The imprecise nature extends to the representation of Roman numerals as shown in experiment 1. The second system that adults have is the small exact number system. The system allows us to perceive the exact quantity. It works quickly, but it's limited to just somewhere between 3 or 4 objects. And finally, we have the large exact number system. This system is used to represent the exact quantity of a large number of objects, but it is tied to verbal counting. If you didn't know how to count, or if you are prevented from counting, you would have a hard time doing the odd-even task in experiment 4. I hope that you have found this mini-series on MATLAB and Psychtoolbox useful. Programming may seem daunting before you learn it, but it is quite fun and informative. This is the more controllable aspect of doing science. No matter what your coding problem is, you will always have a solution. Not so for science itself. Science is also quite fun and informative, as we've seen in looking at the data from the number experiments, but science is not deterministic, The solutions and conclusions we reach are almost always probabilistic. When you know how to program, you can concentrate your effort on other aspects of science. Programming also helps build an intuitive sense about what the task is about because you can easily test yourself. And programming allows you to spell out details underlying your science. This completes our mini-series on MATLAB and Psychtoolbox.